Hello, today I'm going to walk you through the setup and configuration of the Knick Stratos Multi transmitter. Before you begin, ensure your power supply, sensor cables, and any outputs you are utilizing are connected to the terminal box on the back of the transmitter. After applying power, you will notice that we currently have an error icon and the screen is red. This is because we have not yet configured the transmitter for our Memosens sensors. We'll be configuring this Stratos Multi for dual channel Memosens pH and conductivity measurements. Let's get started by entering the operator level of the parameter setting menu. First, press the menu button and then toggle to the right to parameter setting. After pressing enter, scroll down to operator level and press enter to go into the menu. If prompted for a passcode here, please note that the default is 1246. The first menu we will configure is our general operation menu. Within this menu, we can select the displayed language, our desired units and formats such as degrees Fahrenheit and PSI, and our displayed measured values for the main screen. If you have purchased the option for the measurement recorder, it can be configured within this menu as well. We will select our desired units of measurement as well as our displayed values on the main screen. The left square button will take us back to the main parameter setting menu. Now, let's configure the 4 to 20 milliamp outputs and the relays from the device. If utilizing any digital inputs for flow control or placing the transmitter in hold mode, they can also be configured within this menu. Scroll down to Inputs, Outputs, and press Enter. For this transmitter, we will configure two 4 to 20 milliamp outputs, one for pH and one for conductivity, as well as one high-level pH relay. As you can see, the output can be turned off if not in use. We will turn output 1 on and configure it for a pH value from 3 pH to 10. Lastly, we can define the milliamp output of the device when in failure mode to be either 3.6 milliamp or 22 milliamp. This can be done in the Behavior During Messages folder. Let's back out of output 1 and continue configuring output 2 for conductivity from 0 microsiemens to 500 microsiemens. Next, we will set up our relay contact K1 for a high limit value of 9 pH. As you can see, we can define our hysteresis, the normal state of the contact, as well as any on-off timing delays for the relay. Once the inputs and outputs are configured, we can then move on to our sensor selection outputs that are found in the main parameter settings menu. The Stratos Multi is capable of taking in up to two sensor inputs with the installation of an additional measuring module. By pressing enter on sensor selection, we can configure our process variables for both channel 1 and channel 2. Because both of our sensors are Memosens sensors, we will select auto recognition for the process variables. Lastly, we want to ensure the calibration settings are set up for both our Memosens pH and conductivity sensors. To do this, we will first set up our pH calibration settings by selecting channel 1 Memosens pH in parameter settings. Here, we will scroll to Cal Pre-Settings and press enter. We recommend Calmatic, or automatic calibration, which provides buffer recognition and temperature compensation automatically. You will see that once you have selected Calmatic under calibration mode, it then offers us the ability to select which buffer set we are using. The most common buffer set on the market is NIST Technical. You can verify the buffers you are using by the labeling on your bottles. Next, we have the ability to select our default number of calibration points, followed by the drift check of the sensor. Lastly, under CAL presettings, the calibration timer allows us to set either a fixed interval or an adaptive evaluation based off sensor loads for indication that a calibration is needed. Please remember that these are default calibration settings which we are configuring. These settings can always be changed by the operator at the beginning of any calibration procedure in the CAL menu. We'll repeat the process for the conductivity sensor on channel 2, this time selecting manual for the CAL mode. The final step of configuring the Stratos Multi transmitter is setting up the HART communication protocol. If utilizing HART communication to your control system, you have the capability of not only selecting the main process values, but also the Memosens diagnostic values. For our setup, we will enable the sensophase status for our pH and conductivity sensors on the second and third HART values. This will ensure continuous feedback to our control system on the health of our measurement loops. This rounds out setup and configuration of our Stratos Multi transmitter. We're now ready to return to measurement mode by pressing the right square button and go online. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out our other videos on the Stratos Multi transmitter by Knick.